Epinephrine usually increases heart rate, but norepinephrine causes a decrease in it. Do you know why that is so? Let's see. Epinephrine and norepinephrine both are adrenergic drugs. Epinephrine acts on all the adrenergic receptors, namely alpha-1, alpha-2, beta-1, and beta-2. Whereas norepinephrine acts only on alpha-1, alpha-2, and beta-1. It does not have beta-2 activity. First, let's see what happens when we give epinephrine. Beta-1 receptors are mainly found in heart, including SA node. Stimulation of these receptors by epinephrine causes an increase in heart rate. Thus, the direct effect of epinephrine causes a rise in heart rate. But the game is not over yet. We also have alpha and beta-2 receptors. The alpha receptors are found in blood vessels, where they cause vasoconstriction. This tends to increase blood pressure. But in some blood vessels, we have beta-2 receptors, and they cause vasodilatation. This vasodilatation tends to decrease blood pressure. Thus, there are tendencies in both directions. The net result is some rise in blood pressure. Now, we know that the baroreceptor reflex opposes changes in blood pressure. Here we have a rise in pressure. So the reflex mechanism tries to decrease it. And one way of doing so is slowing down the heart. Thus, the reflex mechanism tends to slow down the heart. But we previously saw that the direct action of epinephrine on the heart tends to increase the heart rate. Putting everything together, again we have tendencies in both directions. In the case of epinephrine, the direct action on the SA node usually dominates, and we get an increase in heart rate. In a nutshell, epinephrine causes tachycardia. Now let's go to the norepinephrine. It also acts on beta-1 in the heart and tends to increase heart rate by direct action. But the story is different on the reflex side. Here, the norepinephrine only has alpha action and no beta-2 action. So we see only vasoconstriction by alpha receptors, which increases blood pressure. There is no beta-2 mediated vasodilatation. Because of this unopposed alpha action, there is a marked rise in blood pressure. Compare it with the epinephrine, where the rise was relatively small. As the rise in blood pressure is more here, the reflex is also stronger. Thus, with norepinephrine, the reflex inhibition of the heart is stronger, and the tendency to decrease heart rate is also stronger. As we just saw, here also, the direct action of norepinephrine is trying to increase heart rate. But the reflex is so strong that usually, the reflex inhibition predominates. Because of this, we usually see reflex bradycardia when we give norepinephrine. I hope you now understand clearly why norepinephrine causes reflex bradycardia. If you understood, let me tell you one bonus point. If we give a high dose of epinephrine, there is a marked rise in blood pressure. In that case, the reflex gets stronger, and we may see a decrease in heart rate, even with epinephrine. So this was all the detail. Now let's have a quick summary. The norepinephrine does not have beta-2 activity, which tends to decrease blood pressure. So with unopposed alpha action, there is a marked rise in blood pressure. This rise in blood pressure reflexively inhibits the heart, leading to bradycardia. That's it for this video. You can find the notes and explore our entire video library on our website. The links are in the description. If you like our content, please share it with your friends and colleagues too. It helps us continue creating the content. Thanks for watching, see you in the next video.